We're in South Africa, in Durban, at the 2016 International AIDS Conference. I'm Dr. Gina Brown. I'm an obstetrician gynecologist. I work at the National Institutes of Health and the Office of AIDS Research. My area of interest and concept is women who living with HIV, and then prevention in with microbicides. I'm here today to talk a little bit about some of the really exciting things that we've seen happen here with data being presented on HIV in women. And I think one of the first things really came about during our both the opening session and then has been talked about again later today, and apparently a number of sessions, and it's this idea that we need to think about women and men who have sex with men together, not as a divide, and think about the kinds of resources we need to have to address this epidemic that's happening in both of these populations so severely. The epidemics can sometimes look quite different in different places. In the U.S., we see it tremendously among men who have sex with men, and in particular young black men. In some particular neighborhoods, we see it in a very concentrated way in women. But if you look at sub-Saharan Africa, it's very much a women's epidemic, although we're also seeing it in men as well. And so I think this idea that we come together and work together is tremendous. Some of the exciting things that have happened, I think, at this conference are trying to unpack why women living in sub-Saharan Africa are at such much greater risk, making those relationships with that their partners are by and large 8 years older than they are when you're talking about women under the age of 25. And some of these men also have partnerships with women between 25 and 40 themselves. So this vulnerability of young women is an important issue. People are starting to unpack the biology of why young women may be infected, looking at bacterial vaginosis and in particular particular organisms that they may have that put them at much greater risk for HIV infection. And then I think some even very exciting things that are happening is, as we're looking at, how do we look at long-acting antiretrovirals, things that you can use as an injection for 3 months at a time to prevent HIV infection. We're having the very beginning studies to establish whether they're safe and whether women find them a reasonable thing to use. Trip Gulick from New York presented some data showing that when women receive that injection, it's actually appeared to be quite safe, very minimal side effects, and they're quite willing to do it. So I think we're making real strides toward efforts in prevention in women, efforts in understanding the things that put women at risk, and hopefully we can begin to put that together to look at ways to prevent HIV infection and manage HIV infection.